Hello.
Hi, Terry. It's Jesse and JD. How are you?
Oh, good. Hey, Jesse, JD. How are you guys?
We're bored, Terry. We're bored.
Oh, yeah, I hear you.
How many people are there right now? How many people are you with?
Well, for the most part, it's just me by myself down here in the basement. I can hear people creaking upstairs, but you know, I'm all by myself.
That was a test. I wanted to make sure you were self-isolating. We hear it's very important to do that right now, Terry.
Yeah, I am self-isolating. That's a fact. So luckily, I got the Sega Genesis going. I've been playing a lot of NHL 94, so I'm getting real good at that.
Awesome. Now, Terry, we wanted to bring something up to you because we saw down in Edmonton, there is some Bob and Doug McKenzie statues.
Oh, yeah, I heard about that. They're just sort of sitting there being hosers permanently.
And we thought, what about Terry and Diener statues in Calgary?
You know, that's a really good idea, you know, but I think you guys are, like, leading the cart before the horse, so to speak, because, like, you know, they could just pay me to go sit there for a while. You know, I could be, like, on a schedule. Like, you could just be like, oh, Terry's going to actually be sitting there.
What kind of money would you be looking for that? Just out of curiosity.
Oh, you know, like, whatever that old minimum wage was would do for me.
Really? No hazard pay?
Well, it depends. Like, right now in the current climate, for sure, I'd need like a hazmatted pay or something, like something where people can't get too close. But on a normal Sunday or whatever, I'd sit there for 15, 20 bucks an hour, no problem.
Now, we know you're the Duke of Ogden. Is that where you would want the Terry Cahill live statue to be? Or what part of the city would you want to be sitting in?
Well, you know, I'd probably go with like the actual facts. You know, like the facts from when that documentary was made. And a lot of people are like, where was that house? Like, where were you living when that was made? And a lot of people think it was Forest Lawn or Ogden or you know, different, or Bowness even. But the truth is, it was right downtown, like right off like 8th Street and like, got to count up, like 18th and like 8th Street, then 19th Avenue. And now it's a bunch of condos, but it used to be a house that was like sort of run down there. I'd put it right on that corner. That's where we hooked the two-liner. That's where I'd put it.
Remember the two-liner? The two-liner was friggin' sweet. For the record, the documentary FUBAR really does hold up in these times. I recommend everybody watching the hell out of that. Now, what happened to the house? Like were you, like you say it's condos now, were you guys renting? Did you own that house? What was the story there?
No. It was one of those sweet scenarios. Like, I don't know, I'm sure your friends have been in a situation where it's like, oh, we own this house and it's a piece of crap, but we can't quite get it developed yet. Let's find some suckers to rent it out until we kick them out. You know, so it was super cheap. Like, it was awesome because I normally probably wouldn't live that close to the city center. So those are fond memories. Like, you could just wander right down.
Probably not so fond memories of one day just like a wrecking ball showing up and you finding out you had to get the hell out because they're about to knock it the hell down.
Yeah, but it came at the right time. Like, that was a time to turn the page in our life because, like, Farrell sort of, you know, it was hot that day in the river and all that. So we were like, let's get out of here because it kind of reminds us of sort of some of the bad news. But the other thing I was going to say, like, I know you're saying brass statues of, you know, like, but maybe I could just start with like a bobblehead or something more simple, because like that's a lot of, we'd have to find a statue guy maker, whatever them's called. And then you got to cast it in bronze and maybe, I don't know. But anyway, that's what I'm thinking. I could go in person for now or pretend to be a statue, or maybe we can get a bobblehead.
So you do not want us to push forward a motion to get a Terry Cahill statue here in Calgary?
Oh, no, I'll do it for sure. Let's go. And I'd even get that guy. I don't remember his name, but he lives near the Bar U Ranch and he does all the like brass horses and stuff that you see at the airport, the really good ones.
Oh, yeah.
That guy, I can't remember his name, but I could find out and we could be like, hey, sure, I'll come sit down and get wrecked and you can look at my face and make it happen.
Well, just in the interest of a pretty broke city that was pretty friggin' broke before the world shut down, maybe we do look at some cost-saving measures and we just get some gold spray paint. Like, I don't know how open to that you are, but it would be a great way to just kind of cut the cost down here when it comes to a Terry statue.
Yeah, that's a good idea. How about once we get the all clear, I'll get brass is probably way too expensive, but yeah, bronze, and then I'll just sit still and we can be like, okay, let's see how it goes.
I think the city needs a place where everybody can congregate and just crush Pilsner and then just leave the cans at the feet of the statue. That would be a perfect place to do it.
Oh, and that could be like a tip at the end of the day for me. I'd be like, sweet, I get the empties.
Not terrible. We just pay you in empties. I don't hate that.
Yeah.
In addition to devastating opponents with Jeremy Roenick in NHL 94, best player on the game by a friggin' mile, what else have you been doing, if you don't mind me asking? I don't mean to pry, but I'm just fascinated to see what different people are doing with all this free time we've been allotted, Terry.
Yeah, at first I just started rooting through old boxes to see what was there. and then I got through them all, and there wasn't a lot. And to be honest, I got the camera there, and I turn it on every now and then onto the YouTube and just talk to people. And that, to me, is probably the most exciting part, because I'm, like, sitting alone just staring at the ceiling. But when I turn that on, then it's like, oh, hey, Tara from Ontario or whatever. That, to me, is the best part, is just reaching out and chatting with people. Like, even this is probably the best thing that's going to happen to me today, talking to you guys.
Thank you. How many beers are you averaging every time you hop on YouTube?
Everyone's asking me that. Like, it's hard, because at first I was like, I got nothing to do tomorrow. And then the next day, I got nothing to do tomorrow. So I ripped right through my supply really quick. And then I was like, whew, I can't keep this up. So now I'm kind of like bowing back and forth. Like, sometimes I'll be like, okay, it's kind of a weekend on a Wednesday this week, because it doesn't matter. But then I'll be like, okay, Thursday's a Monday, then Friday's a real Friday. Stuff like that.
Somewhere in there's definitely some logic. Did I see correctly that you and Trish linked up on Instagram Live as well?
We did. And she's locked down too, and I'm gonna try to keep calling her too, because that felt really good. She's beautiful, and just to see her face, you know, reminds me that once this thing's all clear, I'm gonna try to like get it right again.
You know, JD and I are also bored. If you ever want to call us up for Instagram Live as well, we'd love to hop on and crush a couple with you.
Okay, let's do it. Like, we can, obviously you guys are morning guys, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we gotta have some early morning. So I'm gonna treat today like Monday, and then maybe tomorrow could be a Friday or something, or maybe Wednesday's Friday.
Tuesday's the new Friday from where I'm sitting, Ter. Makes a whole lot of sense to me, buddy.
Okay, well maybe we can have like an end of your shift. I don't even know what your shift is. Like, I know you're shift workers, but you know, whenever you're done, we could like wrap it up with some beers. Cause I don't want to get wrecked too early. Cause then it screws up what weekend day it is.
You get too piled up on a Tuesday saying Tuesday is the new Friday before you know it, you've ruined Monday, which is the new Thursday, right?
You got it. You totally got it. So I know a lot of people might not understand it, but once you get into it, you're like, okay, yep, that was a weekend night.
I'm in. Whatever you're selling, I'm buying, so.
Okay, so tomorrow will be a Friday afternoon when you guys are done work?
Yeah, ish. Yeah, it's all. We've lost track of all time around these parts.
Okay.
So.
Pull out the old flip phone and shoot us a text whenever you want to jump on, and we'll make sure we jump on with you.
Okay, I'll pencil it in on the wall.
Sorry, on the wall?
Yeah, that's where I'm writing all my best ideas.
Are you ticking off days on the wall as well? I've seen a lot of people doing that, just doing the slash marks for each day they've been in self-isolation.
Yeah, like the prisons, yeah, a little bit. But then again, weekends I do extra scratches because I'm in a good mood, and then I don't even know how many days are left or how many I'm even counting up to.
The year is 2020, Terry, just to clear that up as well.
Yeah, and it blows so far, but hopefully it'll blow away, and you know, by the time I'm still telling people maybe May 2-4 will be allowed out, hoping.
That feels like ambitious talk, but you know what? I want to believe that too. Hopefully May 2-4 is a go.
Well, especially if everyone hunkers down properly. Like, I still see some knobs just like, oh yeah, hey, let's just hang out like business as usual. It's like, quit worrying, like, don't worry about you, like, worry about everyone else. So just stay in.
Don't hesitate to grab a can of vitamin P and huck a proper two-liner right at those people if you see them out there wandering about in large groups like that, okay?
Good call. I mean, it's hard to huck through a basement window, but if I get the angle right, I might get it out.
Thanks, Terry. Listen, I know we can't see you through the pea soup, but
we'll send that thing around. We'll do the beacon.
Thanks, buddy.
See you, pal.
Give her. Woo.